There you go. Old heat waves. September 26th and it's nice out. What does it say? 21 Celsius, but I think it's like 24 or something. That just came out of the truck. So, yeah, good old El Nino. Woohoo! Yeah, right down to the left here. Walker Falls. I don't know. Did you miss it?
Well, I don't know.
I'm not sure where it is. No, yeah, right here. No, that's not it. Further, it's further then.
Okay.
We're lost. I thought it was right there.
We're out on a beautiful fall day.
Yeah, we sure are. Where did he go? I thought it was right there. I think it's grown in.
Yeah.
So, yeah. Road at Tabor Lake area. Oh, Sandy Point Camp Road. Whatever, Forbes Corners, you name it. That's where we started. And Team MudPro are in their Wildcat. And they wanted to go and see the Tabor Lake Mine and the Sakoose Mine. So we're going to go take a tour. But it's a beautiful darn day in the neighborhood. We were looking for a trail in here that goes down by the waterfalls. And right in there, I think.
Yeah, I think it's kind of grown in, though.
It's all grown in, eh?
Yeah, I think it's right.
Yeah? Oh, well, that doesn't matter. So, I guess we'll skip that, but there's Walker Falls, it's right there. Been here a couple times before, you can't really get the full effect, they drop off right over there. And there's that little beach I think that trail went to, but... So anyways, yeah. Didn't see any ticks here today. Just do it with my coat. And yeah, we're going to carry on and do a little exploring. You ready?
Yeah, sure am.
Away we go. Cutting up some wood.
Oh, yeah.
I guess it's been almost like a year exactly till since we were here last year. There's some pretty nice colors, but I don't know, this year has been drier, so it might not be. We'll find out. So yeah, we're just cruising along towards Tabor Lake Mine, and road's growing in a little bit, but nothing too bad yet. I guess, I don't know, I don't see anybody, they must still be going. Oh yeah, I see orange. It is small game hunting season. Might be others too. What?
Mining claim stick there.
Yeah. Yeah, so we're just about at those old relic cars, if they're still there. I don't see any tracks where they took them out, so stop in and take a ride in one of them, maybe.
Oh, tree in the face.
I heard that. We told MudPro Man just pull up to the pullout, and we'd stop here, but he missed it, and he took off. Bye. But yeah, is it ever grown up? Is that Shaggin' Wagon? Yeah, right in there, the Shaggin' Wagon and the other car, and the other three are back there. We'll go take a look. So that was pretty cool. Didn't take any video there, but we took some pictures of those old cars and the old panel wagon, whatever you call it. And we're going to carry on towards the mine. But apparently there's a tree across the road up here. Might have to use some kung fu tactics on it. Well, you can see the lake right in there, Tabor Lake. Leaves are turning here a bit. It is getting brushy in here.
Yeah.
Nice colors, though.
Yeah, it's more yellows here.
Is it ever romantic?
Romantic.
Oh, yeah. For sure.
Ah.
that's Tabor Lake. You can kind of see it through the trees. And the name of the mine was Tabor Lake Mine, so that's why it got called that. And we think the mine shaft went under the lake as well partway, so Cubby's wheeling.
So yeah, that's some of the tailings from the shaft. Oh, I could just see it up there through the trees. There should be a trail here somewhere, but I don't see it yet.
Right there, isn't it?
No. Matter of fact, it isn't. Oh yeah, right here. Going up.
Yeah, leafy, red.
Leafy little trail. Rocky. Some metal and stuff in here. Oh. Oh, oh, hey! Yeah, darn nice colors up here. There it is. We've been here before, but, you know. Part of the tour is, like, included with your package. 1960. This one's not as old as the ones at Gold Rock, but still counts. I forget how deep they said this one was on the internet. 300 and some feet, maybe? I think it goes down and there's levels going under the lake.
So we're at the Tabor Lake Mine and the shaft is all fenced off. And I don't know if you can really see much in there, but as we go through the mesh, it's concrete. And then way down there is just an empty hole. So it looks like this headframe was in 1960, so not near as old as Gold Rock, but nevertheless, they've left some stuff still here. Lots of old tailing piles, so you never know. Maybe one day they might come back. And it's always exploration going on in the area.
So yeah, it's more of the tailing piles, I think, from the mine. We're out of there now. That's Tabor Lake again there. And we're gonna make our way out of here, cut across country over to the Sakoose. I think that's what it's called, Sakoose. Wasn't it called something else? Sakoose,
I don't know. I thought it was Sakoose.
Sakoose. O-O-S-E, I think. I don't know. And it was big something like elephant or I don't know. Should have looked it up before we left. But it doesn't really matter because that's just where we're going. There's the lake. I bet you if it would have been another week or two later in here, you'd been able to see all over the place. You'd probably see all sorts of cool things. Oh, well. No ticks, at least. This is probably going to be the only mud we see today. Maybe. I don't know. Just a couple of wet mud puddles. Still kind of counts, I guess. A little more up here. Oh.
The wallowing.
Wally the wallower. Oh, shake the guts right out of you, though. Oh, I'm losing you. It's a little tight fit for that wildcat, but not too bad. Hasn't had no problem getting in here. A little brushy, but not too bad at all. Hey, a wildcat. A wildcat and a grizzly bear. Okay?
Yeah.
Yeah. I guess so. Go up here.
Yeah.
Now I can figure out where we gotta go. So, yeah, this, I think, is turnoff. There looks like a track in here, though. I just loaded our tracks from last year on here, and then we reset the odometer when we get here, and they're gone again. I don't know, this thing gives us a hard time every time. But, you know, we are in here, so.
I think this is where maybe the mill was, and in the Sakoose Mine, and I've walked up there before, and you can see every so often is one of these big concrete type blocks, so I'm thinking it went right up the hill. And up there too, you can see the wall, and it's a bit of a trail there to another concrete pad up there. Pretty cool.
Bunch of wooden culverts here. What is that in there? What is that?
What?
I don't know, I see a handlebar thing sticking up. There's an old bus and stuff in here. The shaft, I think, is right in here. We'll check it out. Yeah. Oh, actually, that's where I put the mark for the shaft. That's not my coordinates from the internet.
It's right there, isn't it?
Yeah, right there. So, yeah, I don't know why theirs would be wrong.
Well, this one is the shaft at Sakoose Mine, and it's full of water. Not a lot of fencing on this one.
Water lines are here.
Is there?
So we've come across this channel cut out of the rock, and it's all fenced off with barbed wire, so, which is good, so people can't get in there, but the cut just keeps going and going. So it goes straight down there and just cut right up there. There's some timbers and goes as far as you can see. Kind of cool. And then here it's kind of caved in, so.
So yeah, that was Sakoose. Didn't it used to be called, I couldn't think, something about a whale. I said that before, didn't I? Golden whale? Is that it?
I don't know, unless that's another one.
No, it had two names, but anyway, it doesn't really matter, you know. We're out of there, and CK took some pictures, and nothing really to see, but I think we're going to tour down towards Sandy Point Camp because it's a pretty nice little ride down the road there. And, yeah. What time is it? 4 o'clock?
I don't know the time.
This one says 4, but I don't know if it's been adjusted or what.
Yeah, so that's the right time.
Oh, well, then it's 4 o'clock. We're just going to take a little peek in here at Sandy Point Camp. We must be just about there. It's getting a little dusty now. It hasn't been, but pretty nice little drive in here, let me tell you. We must be there, right? Almost?
I think so.
Oh, you got the GPS.
Oh yeah, almost there. Around the corner.
Around the corner. We'll keep the cameras rolling.
Here we are.
Here we are.
Four-wheeler track.
Four-wheeler track. I guess you can hear it.
Oh, couple four-wheelers.
Anybody home?
I don't know. Truck's here.
It's a nice spot on the lake. Can't watch the gamic.
Maybe I'll just pull up here.
I'll pull over here. So it was just a quick visit. The owner was just leaving to go into town, so caught him just in time. Nice spot though. Found this awesome place here. Now we're going to turn around and see if we can find those colors from last year. Well, not the same ones, but... get her done! So here's where the good colors were last year. They're not too bad this year. Not quite there yet.
Well, some are.
Pretty good, though.
Yeah.
You really got to drive a long ways in here to see them. And there's piles of bear crap, oh, like that, everywhere. And grouse everywhere. I think my exhaust sounds louder. Peppy. I think that's where we turned around, isn't it?
Yeah.
That bump right here.
Watch for bear.
Man. Clear cut.
So the reds are just kind of starting. I don't know if they're as red as they were this time last year, but still really pretty.
Well, we just stopped for a drink and it's getting pretty late. Be dark by the time we get home, but there is some pretty awesome colors in this little valley here, all right. Pretty nice, all right. I don't know what kind of trees those would be, but we notice there's a big cliff up there. Squatch. Stop and document this pile of bear crap because it is ginormous. look at it, it's like red.
I guess they've been eating Saskatoons or...
I don't know what. Take a sample there.
You first.
I think there was a bigger pile than that. I had to put it in four-wheel drive to get through it. Those look like pin cherries.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, for sure it does. Good thing we didn't step in it.
Okay.
Look at, there are piles everywhere here. Oh, I think I rode in some.
Oh, here's the bigger pile.
There's bigger yet? Yeah, they're all checking it out. They can't get over it. He needs a backup light on that thing. Holy!
Park next to it so you get the idea here.
You can even see the bugs flying around it. Look, like they didn't even digest those berries. So you could just, like, make jam out of that. 10 to 6, it'll be dark soon. Not a lot of... Whoa, I passed it. Not a lot of four-wheeling action, but some good exploring. Pretty well the same ride we took last year, but MudPro Man had never been there, so yeah. Fun, no? The beast is... Hey, that trailer started moving. The beast is getting beastlier. I don't know. But she seems to be getting peppier all the time. So yeah, that's going to wrap it up. Hope you enjoyed the little video, and we'll see you all next time.
Thanks, everybody.
Thanks for coming out, having a look.